anything frame. We see the culture of that nation. As reflected in the shame of Sydney this very weekend. Surely we sadly and desperately need a change. A change to our world, our world's environment, our world's culture. For God to change the planet. That He can make it a place of righteousness and joy. I was interested to hear today's Clean Up Australia Day. Clean Up Australia Day, that's today. I think it's good timing after the Mardi Gras, isn't it? Clean Up Australia, that's a good thing. He's going to be seated on that throne. It says there's going to be no more curse. There'll be a new environment. There won't be a curse on the earth. There won't be a fallen planet. It's going to be restored, renewed, made new. And what's more, it says heaven will be a place of joyful service and activity. A new employment. Now, some would picture heaven as us sitting on clouds and strumming harps. Maybe we'll get that kind of harp lessons, you know? Maybe we'll learn how to play a harp. I don't know. Of course, that's just someone's imagination. But honestly, heaven will be a place of activity. We won't be sitting there in holy hammocks and just wasting eternity away. But there's actually going to be some engagement in heaven. Heaven is going to be a place of joyful service and activity. There's going to be no one unemployed there. You won't be standing in unemployment queues trying to get a welfare check. There's going to be no one sick or injured or not able to be employed there, because you'll have full ability. No one will be short of some useful activity that will get some reward them. How can we imagine it? Can we reckon that one day heaven is a place where his servants shall serve him? That's going to be joy. This is going to be joyful. There'll be purposeful, meaningful work for all to do. You'll find an engagement in this kingdom that occupies you and transforms you. To serve the King, to serve the Lord. That's wonderful. This is not an irksome thing. To be occupied, to be transformed by the one who is the Lord. And he invites us, it says, to this wonderful fulfillment, to be in his service. Have you met this master yet? He says to you, occupy till I come. There's a Bible verse that, as a parable, teaches how we should be occupied as we're expecting our Lord to come back. Friends, I put to you today, you can live life purposefully now in his service. You don't have to wait till heaven for you to serve God, right? You can serve God now. You don't have to wait till heaven. You can have a new allegiance now, a new Lord. And this change can mean you count every day a new opportunity to be occupied with his kingdom, living with eternity in view. Maybe it's moving someone's furniture. That can be an occupation you can do, isn't it? There's practical things you can do. There's practical ways you can show love. There's practical ways you can care. In your workplace, in your work settings, you can live honourably. Be occupied with living with eternity in view. When you become his servant, your priorities change too. There's a new change. There's a new thought process. What really matters is how I use what time I have. Friends, he has an assignment for everyone. He has an appointment, a position just for you. You're perfectly fitted for it. Sometimes I think we miss that. We decline the offer. But because we know the Lord Jesus, he gives us a fresh sense of what we can dare and do for his glory. sends a very